Om Namah Shivaya. Everybody, welcome to this first satsanga with question and answers. All these question and answer are question and answer related to the scripture I was explaining during a long seminar, during many hours. So my disciples were told to write down question. Question coming to them yet during the seminar, and now they can answer. One by one.
Guruji, what is the difference between Vijnana Kala and the state of Vijnana Kala?
Vijnana Kala and the state of Vijnana Kala. This is very interesting question. It's a very subtle question. It's the difference between the dasha or avastha and the state. Between the state of Vijnana Kala and the Vijnana Kala state. The same for the state of Shiva and how to explain this. No, the question is more subtle. It's like this. Vijnana Kalas are the experience of the state of Vijnana Kala. But there is another state, that is the state of the experience or knower of the state of Vijnana Kala. This is a greater state. So you have the state of Vijnana Kala and you have the state of the pramata or the experience of Vijnana Kala. So this may be the question, yes, because the difference between Vijnana Kala and the state of Vijnana Kala is one is the experience, another is the state being experienced, yes, very simple. So maybe he's trying to say that the difference between the state and the state of the experience. And this is not only about Vijnana Kala, it's about any state. For example, you say mantra maheshwara vasta or mantra maheshwara dasha, the state of mantra maheshwara, or mantra maheshwara pramatri dasha or pramatri avasta, the state of the experience of mantra maheshwara. The difference is that the state of mantra maheshwara or the state of Shiva, yes, for example, or the state of Vijnana Kala or Mantreshwara or Mantra, yes, is coming but without your will. Without your will. Oh, we need to fix this. Without your will. You, my way. Without your will. While the state of the experience of the state, yes, this is the will. For example, Shiva Vasta Pramatria Vasta or something like this, or Dasha, is the state of the experience of the state of Shiva. So it's at will. So you have control over the state. But you can enter the state of Shiva without your will, yes, by accident sometimes, yes, you are state of Shiva. The state of Vijnana Kala is the state of Shiva, but without Swatantra, yes. Or the full state of Shiva, yes, without will. So you are meditating on the state of Shiva, yes, but then you cannot return at will. So this is the state of Shiva. If you can return at will, this is the state of the experience or knower of the state of Shiva. Question with the number of stanza, for example, you can write the number of the stanza, yes, and the question associated.
So you said, do they have eight worlds associated with each of the entities?
This entity is Ishvara Tattva. Ishvara Tattva has the names of all the Rudras, all the Vidyeshwaras. Eka Rudra is one of the Vidyeshwaras. It's one of the Vidyeshwaras, and the eight knowers, the lords of knowledge, yes, helping humankind, yeah, remember, Vidyeshwaras. So, in Ishvara Tattva, his name there, yes, you have Shikandi, Shrikanta, Trimurti, Ekarudra, Ekanetra, Shivottama, Sukshma, Ananta. All these are the name of the eight Vidyeshwaras. And so Ekarudra lives in the word Ekarudra, because he's the chief of that word. But they descend to the state of the Paramahamaya, yes, the higher Mahamaya, to help humankind, yes, to help people. Without with help, the people cannot ascend, yes, to higher status, it's impossible. Except you are very devoted, but from other life you were helped, yes. But why you now, you don't need any help.
So Guruji, is it like they are presiding deities of those worlds?
Yes, yes, a presiding deity of those worlds. Yes, yes, this is the right way. Like every world has a presiding deity. It's like Sadashiva, for example, in Sadashiva only one word, Sadashiva Bhuvana. And it's presided by Sadashiva Bhattaraka, yes, Sadashiva, literally. It's raining a lot, very strange. People told me that only in June it's raining.
It's very rare. Hmm? Very rare.
Very rare. So we had to go to lunch, we'll be fresh walking. Yes. But we don't have umbrellas, so what's the problem? Anyway, we'll be wet, not fresh, wet walking. Okay, the snakes come out with raining, yes?
The hide.
They hide, or because a lot of rain, they come out.
A lot of rain, they come out.
Yes. To dry houses, come out. In the direction of dry houses, this house. Okay, another question. You wrote something, yes? Question, okay.
Guruji, how it's possible if aphorism first you have
aphorism?
First. It said like the springboard is always what goes in first place at all the time.
Yes.
So how it is possible to put Shiva at first place in our daily life? Like
obviously, this is the ideal state. It's not that you can do it from the start. Yes, all this. To put Shiva all the time, you need a great state. You have to be very advanced. But this is the ideal goal. To put in the first place, for example, you have to meditate and you have to meditate. If a friend comes at that time, ring the bell, you tell the friend, no, sorry, wait for me half an hour or 1 hour because I have to meditate. Oh, I cannot, okay, so late. Just to push you in the first place. When you are working, obviously, you have to work, yes. It's like this, yes, it's part of the slavery, yes, of this work. But this is the meaning, but this is the ideal state, yes. It's like when you do postures in Hatha Yoga. It's not that you have to do it like, I don't know, like Yenga, yes, like the Kinobasana. No, you start until the position you can, at this position is perfect. Because in Hatha Yoga, the axiom or the maxim is to all the time keep this limit between pain and pleasure, or pleasure and pain. So you have to put your head on your knees, yes? Imagine you cannot do this, yes? You can only, yes, sorry, pain. So you stop. No pain, but not a lot of pleasure. A little pain, a little pleasure, this limit, the limit. And this is perfect. So the same for this teaching about Paramashiva or Shiva, the Lord. But this is the ideal state I postulate, yes, in the aphorism. But you start with what you can, yes, little by little. Now, when you become a great devotee of the Lord, yes, you put so hard, yes, the Lord in the first place that many times, even at the cost of your own life, yes. But this is a great devotee. It depends on your caliber. All the time. But this is the right way to, this is the right, the way to fix your life. To put little by little more and more the Lord in the first time. For everything. It's, you had to chant. For example, when I had to chant, I was tested very hard in my life about this. For example, when I had to chant in the past, my mother disliked my chanting. A Guru Gita, this, all that, so, but I had to chant. So she started to pester me a lot, yes? even I was chanting during the day, not during the night, so she could sleep very well, yes, not disturbing her, but she disliked chanting. So I told my mother, okay, you cannot tolerate my chanting, you have to move to another house. It was my house, not her house. She was living in my house. So, oh, I don't care. If you continue, you had two options, to tolerate or to move. So she tolerated, obviously. She didn't have another house. But a very strong guy myself, a very hard guy, not strong, very tough guy. So you had to go maybe slower. But I came from another life, yes, devotee, so I was very strong in my convictions. And in the future, she adapted and no more problem after this. No more problem. And this kind of attitude. Or with a parent, yes, I have to go to the ashram, yes, to do something. Then, oh, no, why the God, that's strong. It's first place, the Lord. Finish. Or you move to another house. Or they move to another house. But this is very hard. But this is a test, yes, okay. I passed it, and nobody died, yes. I never kid anyone for the Lord, yes, but it's this kind of test, all the time. Because Maya, remember, you relax your effort and Maya takes you again. You know, even when we relax a little, yes, I do it on purpose to check your misery. But when relax a little, during the breaks or something, yes, start with the usual talking, the usual thought, the usual emotion, yes, like a machine, like before, yes. So, again, to say nonsense, to do stupid actions, to... It's a part of the human nature all the time to indulge in idiocy. It's part of the nature. That's why in an ashrama you have to keep an eye on this, yes, on you too. Yes, and all the time with alarm clocks, yes, all the time. That's why the discipline is like an alarm clock. No, the chanting, so all people moving, yes, alarm clock. People dislike alarm clock because they are awakening them. So they prefer to sleep in ignorance. You relax, your ego start to sleep, to talk. Because they all the time start to talk. When you start to eat food, yes, ego start to talk a lot. All the time, the same idiot, how is idiot way like before? With the same opinion, yes, I dislike this and like that, so... This is your misery. You don't want this. You want to stop this, yes, so much as you can. There is all the time a little tribute, yes, to Maya, every day you have to put, yes, according to your state. But you don't want more tribute, yes. When you don't know who you are while you are talking, yes, you are completely lost in your talking, you are paying big tribute to Maya. And, you know, all this, yes. Laziness and okay. You have a question?
Yes, question that Pooja asked, you know, I just want to clarify, you know, ask from you, you said that we have to place Shiva in the first place always, but is that before liberation? Once you are liberated?
I know, before liberation. No.
Once you are liberated, then?
After liberation, you are him, so how to put him in the first place? He's already in the first place. Before liberation, it's for disciples. For liberation, it's not this. No, they know already. They don't need rules. They don't need alarm clocks, so they are awakened. But when you are not awakened, you need some alarm clocks. But you need someone else changing the alarm clocks. Because you put your own alarm clocks, next you sleep better. This is a rule. So you are, because you are sleeping, so you have to remember to wake up to put the alarm clock again, but you sleep again, so you don't remember. So the alarm clock start to become like a sleeper device or something like this, so it's worse. You need a person all the time, David, but now there are batteries, so you need a person all the time activating the alarm clock again, yes, so changing the times, so your ego dislike again, yes, so wake up, yes, different time, change. That's why the practice, and that's why you change I made you change the positions. Or in an ashram, sometimes you change something, yes, in order to break the mechanic thing. Yes. It's complicated, the human being, because there's this law that all becomes mechanic. All becomes mechanic. You relax your effort, your grip, yes, all becomes mechanic. So because why? Because in when you are mechanic, you are relaxed because it's a mechanic, it's a machine. But when you're not mechanic, you have to make an effort. So you are not relaxed. You have to make an effort. Yes, and it's hard. For example, it's easy to indulge in bad emotions. Yes, it's very simple. But it's difficult to indulge in good emotions. So it's more complicated. You have to make efforts. Efforts. The problem with a community like this, the starting community, is that how to keep the mass. Yes, now we are a few only, less than 10. But how to keep the mass more or less, especially in this country, so relaxed country, yes, how to keep the mass on focus. Or they're wasting their time. So if they are training hard, if they are relaxed, even in the ashrama, yes, it's like at home. When they're with the husband and say, yes, in Hindi, I don't know Hindi, something like this. To be like this here, yes, yes. At home with the husband is the same, yes. So, hey, to look at you, hey, watch this, this, to speak like this triviality, yes, don't be here. Go home. You understand? All the time with triviality, and time passes by, yes, and you will die. It's for sure. You will leave the body. So you have to make the most of your time. Speaking elevated things, yes, you have to speak elevated things, yes. But you have to be patient because there is all the time a tribute to Maya every day. You can be free from this tribute, so you are liberated. Every day you have to say some nonsense and to do some nonsense. Check in your life and you will see. Every day you pay tribute to this monster. Very hard monster. It's a very bad mother because kill her own children. She kills her own children. You don't want to serve this power. It's bad. After liberation, oh, it's your own will, laka-laka. Yes, okay. Very funny. But before, it's a real problem. You see, every time break, on purpose, a little longer break, yes, to check you. Because I need to see your misery in order to say, to do something. So you start. First, concentrate. And next, start. What do? Yes, in Hindi, I don't know. I only hear this noise. Yes. What do? What do? Babu, choo-choo. I hear only this. So again, yes, the machine, and the habit, and the bad thought, the stupid thoughts, I don't know, thoughts. This is the tribute to Maya. Misery. Machine is not you. Shiva is not you. Parama Shiva is sublime. It's not trivial or idiot like this. You can speak, obviously. You can speak, but the habit. Never changing even the tone. Yes, to be different, every time the same. That woman all the time with the strong T, final T, so it's hot. All the thought, never change, never hot. Hot, oh, hot. And all the time the same voice, she cannot modify her voice. This is a tribute to Maya. She cannot be different, you cannot be different, you cannot be different, you cannot be different. All the time the same people. This is a mechanic, it's robots. Well, you have the best excuse. You are a robot already. So. But a mechanic, ladies, a robot. All the same, commentary, all the same opinion, the same thoughts. Mechanic. Not free people. The free person is marked by unpredictability. It's unpredictable. If you are predictable, you are mechanic. That's why it's so uncomfortable to be with a free person, because it's unpredictable. And you hate this, because the machine hates unpredictability. We have time, we have 25 minutes.
Guruji, what are four kinds of karma?
What?
What are four kinds of karma?
It's three kinds, really. I made a mistake at that time. I don't know how this in my four kinds. Three kinds is Sanchita karma. Sanchita is accumulated. Means accumulated. Let me check the dictionary. Accumulated. Karma. Sanchita. It's a karma that is not fructifying. Yes? Fructifying in this life. fructify the next life. So maybe you have a karma, for example, of a thief, yes? But in this life you are completely decent, yes? So you say, thief, how is that possible? Now I saw decent, you know, it's for your next life. Very strange. What is this?
Does it affect us, Guruji?
No. The next life. So you get liberation, you burn all these future karma. So you never experience your sick karma, for example. In this life you can be very decent, but you have a criminal karma with you. Yes, Sanchita, heaped up, accumulated, hoarded, collected. Okay. Next you have the agami karma. The agami karma is the karma you are creating now with your actions. For the future, for next lives. Or for this life. But future. Agami is coming later, yes. Agami is coming, but later. And next you have the prarabdha karma, from the verb prarabdha. Prarabdha means began. Because it's a, give me the whiteboard. You can, how is anhang? There is no anhang, yes. How is the kolgar? Anhang?
An inch.
With a marker. Because colgar hang in Spanish. This colgar to take down a frame, to take down, take it down. Take it down. With a marker. Yes, erase. With the eraser, you erase. Very smart. So it's a little big, yes, for having it on the lap, but it's useful. That's why I wanted to write for Nia, yes, so I can write something and then show you, yes, like this. Like these women in the between rounds in boxes. It's a little bulky, but can be useful. So you have next I will show you. You have prarabdha to start, yes? So to create the past participle, prarabdha, yes? Started or began, yes? Began.
Yes, began.
So to create began, the rule is to add ta or na. For this verb, ta. Na is not very usual. So you add ta. But obviously, complicated, because this bha, this is soft consonant, it's reverberating in your throat, yes? Bha, bha. But ta is hard, it's not reverberating. Ta is a hard, it's a dry sound, yes? This is a wet sound, translate like this. So, you have to transform this into a soft letter. So you have in the consonant ta ta da ta na with this melody. It's a long time ago I heard this melody for Sanskrit. Ta ta da ta na, the dental consonant. Yes. So because you know the Vanagari, so you like it. Ta ta da ta na, yes, all this. Okay. So you have to transform ta into da. It's the rule of Sandhi combination. So you put here da. Okay, so you have prarap da. But it's not good sound. So the rule is that when there is a final aspirate consonant like pa, because pa, there is an aspiration, yes. Really it's an expiration, but it's aspirated. Pa. So this consonant, when there is a combination, it's not possible in Sanskrit. this consonant has to lend his aspiration to the last consonant. So, ba is transformed into ba, and da is transformed into da. So the final word is prarabdha. In transliteration, this H moved to the next consonant. And in Sanskrit, ba, the letter ba is ba, transformed into b. And the letter da transform into ta. Understand? Rules. Rules. Now you can see. Here. Because I can use it. So the prarada karma is the karma that already is already begun. The karma which began already. So you cannot stop. Not even with liberation. After liberation, you retain the body. The only way to stop the prarada karma with liberation is the liberation is so hard that you die. Yes? If the revelation of the Lord is so massive, yes, you leave the body because the body cannot survive. And so you destroy all the karma. But if you retain the body, prarada karma stays. That's why you continue to be in the body, yes? Because the karma is the fuel of the life of the body. Yes? Without karma, there is no life. Except you reincarnate already enlightened, like Bhagavān Nityānanda, no karma. Yes? So he created life without karma, but it's very elevated, don't worry. Because complicated the problem with the karma. It's not so simple. Yes, karma. Not all is karma. Some things are accidents, not karma. Karma is only when there is a doer and there are fruits of actions. This is karma. But it's an accident. No karma. But it's very subtle. It's very difficult to say when it's an accident, when it's karma, because some accident by karma. But other accidents, no. No karma. For example, Mother Nature is not driven by karma. Driven, yes, by karma. It's by prakriti. That's why prakriti is called nature. So you are killed by a tornado, it's not karma, maybe. It's an accident. You understand? Maybe. It's very difficult. Karma is very intricate. Very intricate. Because in Spanish we put an N. We say intrincado. So all the time I tend to say intricate, but intricate. And that's why when Arjuna asked Lord Krishna about the karma, Krishna said the karma is very intricate, very complex, very difficult to say exactly. Yes. So you cannot say like ignorant people, it's all is karma, no, it's karma, no, it's karma. Sometimes it's accident. Other teachings, yes, other system explain this like in this way. Accident is related to your false ego. It's very strange teaching. So, for example, your karma is related to your destiny. Something like this. Yes? But it's not so simple because in this system you have destiny, you have karma, and you have accident. So, very complex system, yes, don't go crazy. But in broadly speaking, it's like this. Accident is because of your false ego. Destiny is because your essence, your essence, what you are really. If you are attracting like your essence. And karma is between destiny and accident. That's very complex.
Previous birth's karma affects this
book? Yes, obvious. Sanchita karma. This word or the next word? Agami, this word. Agami karma from your previous life is affecting this life now. Along with prarabdha. Sanchita is not active now. It's from the other life to the next life. Agam is active now along with prarabdha. Accident, I mean, for example, your destiny is to be a poet. For example, yes, because this is what you are, a poet. But you go crazy with your false ego and you become a politician and you receive a bullet in your head. So this is an accident. By destiny, you didn't have to die like this. Maybe you have to love, how is it? About love, yes, out of love. But no, you die with a bullet, by a bullet. So this is accident, because you went crazy with your false ego. So it depends the quantity and magnitude of your false ego, your misery, and affecting or not your destiny. But karma is between destiny and accident, so it's more complex. But not all, please stop, even if you don't master all this teaching, teachings of fourth way, yes, I was speaking about the Gurdjieff teachings and fourth way teaching, because fourth way sometimes separates from Gurdjieff teaching, yes, like Gurdjieff did something, this master, yes, Gurdjieff did something like a renegade, kind of renegade, yes, of the fourth way, so some adaptation. That's why I contacted master teachers of fourth way, and one of them told me, no, I don't mix with Gurdjieff teaching. I belong to the fourth way, yes, or something like this. So it's, you know, some misery there. Yes, in every way it's misery, in yoga too, yes. I belong to this yoga, but it's the other yoga, yes, but now we have this different yoga, something like this. We have something here, yes, even now, yes, with Parabhairavayoga, in order not to be another yoga, but it was the other yoga at first, but now it's not this yoga, it's another yoga. Well, it's misery we have, because we are in here, we pay tribute to Maya. Every time when you suffer, you pay tribute to Maya. This is your misery. That's why try not to suffer as much as you can. So, okay, if a bee sting you, yes, so, okay, you suffer. It's very difficult to escape from it. But you start to suffer for your crazy mind, yes, it's stupid. Imagine you suffer because the rain is wet, something crazy like this, yes, oh, the rain is wet, guys. So this is more tribute to Maya. With a little tribute is enough. Yes. I don't want to pay to that lady anymore. It's not about me, speaking about you. Maya is my ally, but in your case, your enemy.
How to reconnect with self?
How to reconnect with the self? When you have to meditate on the self. The best meditation on the self is the meditation on the witness. But not all people can do this from the start. So they are given mantras, they are given many techniques. Yes. You have 112 techniques in Vijnana Bhairava, the famous scripture in Trika Shaivism. So you have a very good cookbook there, yes, to select your technique. But in my lineage we say, yes, Muktānanda repeated many times, that the best meditation is the meditation on the witness. Because this attracts, the witness is in the state of Turiya. The witness is not in wakefulness, is not in dreaming, is not in deep sleep, it's in Turiya. And because Turiya mixed a little bit, yes, there is some intersection with wakefulness, dreaming and deep sleep. So you have different state of Turiya in deep sleep, in dreaming and in wakefulness, yes, but Turiya anyway is Turiya. It's like there is a limit, there is a frontier. So the frontier, when you go to a frontier, for example, if we go to the frontier with Pakistan, when you reach, before reaching the frontier, yes, when you're far, people speak all the time in what, in Kashmiri, yes. But when you reach the frontier, people start to speak in Pakistani. Pakistani exists, yes.
Urdu,
in Urdu. So, but you say, but it's India. Why speak in Urdu? Because it's a frontier. In the frontier, there is a mixture of both things, yes? So maybe on the side of Pakistan, people speak in Kashmiri too, yes, near the frontier and vice versa. Tricky, 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 because it's the frontier. So in the frontier between Turiya and wakefulness or deep sleep or dreaming, yes, there is a little bit of both kingdoms, yes, at the same time. But the self is purely at the core of Turiya. The only state not mixing with any state is Turiya Tita, the state beyond, even beyond Turiya. This state doesn't mix with any state. And Turiya, what is Turiya? Another name of Turiya. Parabhak. Suṣupti is Parabhak. Supreme speech. So you meditate on the self. The self is a witness to you, to your actions. It's you, but it's a witness to this ego, yes, you think you are. So when you think something, this witness watches the thought. That's why you know that you are thinking. So all the time like this. At first, you think that the witness is not you, it's different from you. You are here and the witness is witnessing you, yes, watching you. But this is only the play of a Shakti, dualistic Shakti, creating this duality, yes, between you and the witness. Little by little, you are sucked by this state, sucked inside by this state, and you become the witness. That you become the witness. That's why when you meditate, in order to become one with the witness, in order to realize the witness, you don't have to judge your thoughts. You are a witness. You are not the judge. You don't say, oh, these are bad thoughts, I dislike, oh, these are good thoughts, I like. No, no, you only watch good thoughts, bad thoughts. But you are not involved. The witness is never involved. Shiva is never involved with any thought, with anything. When you are in a very bad state, yet you are very sad, yes, remember, when you are very sad, you have someone inside you, yes, that is not sad. That's why you know that you are sad. This is the witness. When you see that life is collapsing, yes, something inside you is not collapsing. It's external, the collapse, not internal. He's all the time undisturbed. Meditate on this. Watch on this. Solid. Not in the hands. I'm marking only you. This is solid language. Not only through the eyes, perceiving with the ears, but it's not disturbed. Even when you have, oh, your son died. My God, my son died, but this guy inside. Never moving. And because he's so static, he's so, because it's a compact mass of consciousness, cannot move. Cannot hurry to the tragedy because it's everywhere. It's the tragedy. It's the all in the middle of the tragedy, and you, yes, it's all. It's your son is there, yes, all this distance between you and your son, yes, it's him too, and the son too, and you too, and so it's undisturbed. So when you're in this tragedy, I do it automatically, but people cannot. So you have to try to focus on this undisturbed witness. This guy, this is Shiva, Paramashiva, and it's you. It's completely invulnerable. I couldn't catch the first part.
Meditation technique. You said Om Namah Shivaya, Guru Om.
Yes.
You should meditate on that
itself. You cannot get it, yes, with a witness, because it's very difficult for you to understand or to realize in you, continue with the mantra. Like they say about the mantra, famous saying about the mantra is, repeat the mantra, repeat the mantra. And all this thing you couldn't understand before, you will understand later. Repeat the mantra, repeat the mantra. But if you can understand it, witness, yes, is appearing in you, yes, this intelligence that is never judging. Never judge you, only marks. Yes. Never tell you, oh, you are a bad boy, a bad woman. No, all the time say, okay, bad. Lie. Yes, true. It's like this. It's like a kid. And the tragedy, yes, oh, he's suffering a lot, but he's not suffering. You realize that I'm suffering a lot, but something inside you is completely watching. It's never involved. It's because it's transcendental. It's in Turiya, it's not in wakefulness, nothing. But in the limit, he looks like he's suffering. In the limit with the state. So in the limit between Turiya and wakefulness, yes, there you have some tears, some suffering, some horror, yes? But so apparently it's Turiya, but it's not Turiya, it's a mixture. It's because it's the limit between misery and this state. The same thing when you are dreaming, yes? Apparently you are participating in some action there, but you're not participating. You know this. And in Suṣupti, the winner is alone, but without bliss, because Maya is denying bliss. Yes, and they are namaḥ contracting completely. Denied. So you are only void. But there's no experience, only void. There's no, I only sushruti, there is no wakeful and no dreaming. At least not in the gross ways. That's why you cannot be sad in sushruti. You are sad only wakefulness and dreaming. But most people reach up to that point only, where the deep sleep. They cannot move to Turiya directly. Yogis are marked by this difference, yes, that they can move to Turiya, or at least in theory, yes. Or they are not yogis. They have to move to Turiya at some point. At first they are big, okay, they cannot, but 1 year, 2 years, they need this ability to move to Turiya. Another way to enter into Turiya is by pranayama, by your breathing, not through mantras. You start to pay attention to your breathing, and when your breathing starts to move slower and slower and finally stop, yes, that is you. You glide into Turiya. You move. It's another way to enter the witness state. Turiya is the witness state. The state of the self, the state of the witness. It's all the time, the witness all the time active. That's why you cannot say that I cannot meditate on the witness, because of the whole day. So that's why you know that you do what you dreamt, because the witness was there, yes, watching. That's why after, when you wake up, the witness will tell you, you dream about this, that, inform. That's why you know, because the witness was never dreaming. The witness is not tired. That's why he never slept. In deep sleep, you know, yes, when you come out, you say, oh, I have a very good sleep, or you say, oh, I have no idea what I was dreaming about. But who tells you this? Who tells you this? The witness. Because the witness was awakened the whole time, even in deep sleep. Because he's not tired. The body is tired. That's why when you are very physical, you are not very subtle with this thing. Yes, you are very physical. You all the time sleepy. You all the time obey your body. Yes, your body said, oh, I want to sleep, so you go to sleep. It's very physical, mulatara. It's a mulatara. Yogis are subtler than this, yes. So they can gently, yes, postpone sleep at will, yes, for some other more important pursuit. They are not a slave to sleep.
Witness of aham is
saved. Aham. Obviously, the state of the witness. This is Turiya. When you penetrate into Turiya, you are invulnerable. Because nobody can affect you, because in the middle of a tragedy, yes, you are not affected. You feel the pain, yes, but far from you. You only feel in the intersection. There is some pain there, yes, but far from you. You are in the center. So in the intersection between this Turiya, yes, as it were, for you to understand, yes, and wakefulness, yes, you see some crying there, yes. It's you, yes, but it's not you. It's your body is crying, but it's there, not here. You are here. And your eyes are there, crying. Do you understand? The sensation is like this. Yes, so people, it's difficult to recognize a yogi, great yogi, for this. Because maybe he's crying. But it's a yogi, but he's inside like this. Consciously like this. But his eyes are crying, or suffering, or say, oh, it's painful, it's something. But far from it. That's why I had to recognize him. Maybe he's acting. Nobody knows. Or maybe he stopped the eyes to cry, yes, and he's completely stable. At that time you recognize, you know, this guy is different. Yes? But because he stopped. But he permits the crying, yes, you can recognize. It's like the common people, crying and suffering. All the time devastated. To live like this, all the time devastated. I grab a gun and shoot my head. I put a bullet in my head. To live like this now. Imagine I have a family. Every person dying and devastated for months, years. What's the point of living? What's the point? It's crazy. All the time your happiness depending on a person, on an accident, or some stupid guy with a gun killing your son. What's the point of living like this? But they live like this, and they continue. They want to live more, yes, and they suffer a lot, and they are all the time asking. They are all the time stupefied, all the time asking why, or accusing other people. There's nothing. There's nobody to be accused. Only your ignorance. You created this, you suffer. You want children, okay? Be ready to suffer. Don't play anyway. It's your manifestation. I have never children, at least not consciously. If I have a child around, still not knocking the door, sorry. But not consciously, no. My decision. And why? Because I don't want to suffer more. Yes? You have a child? Okay, you know what you are doing. Don't blame. Someday your child is 20 and some stupid guy with a gun and drug, yes, so kill your son. Okay. It's part of the risk of your company. Yes, it's like a company. You put a company, you assume the risk. Yes. Don't blame. Suffer only, but don't blame anyone. It's your problem. To accept this requires a higher consciousness. It's your manifestation. When you put spiritual soul in human bodies, is risky. Be ready. Yes. Don't be surprised. This world, yes, so dangerous. It's a very dangerous world. Yes. At any moment, a snake, at any moment, Chalmaxi, at any moment, even when you go with your car, yes, on especially in this route, yes, in India, it's so dangerous. Yes. At any moment, some crazy guy, boom, yes, kill a lot of people. So it's risky. You want a family? Okay, risky. Be ready. Be wise. Because all the time blaming other people, blaming destiny, blaming the government, blaming the weather, blaming, it's useless. You are guilty. Yes? In a good way guilty. Yes, you are responsible. Okay. Silent, suffering silent, like I did myself, yes, when I suffer for deaths of people, yes? And stop with the crusade, yes, against someone. Stop, yes, because if there is someone guilty, it's you. And if you want someone else, Maya, yes, finish it. Shakti, Maya, finish. It's not a person, it's an energy, it's a power, for some reason. So it's like this. And if you want more risk, bigger family. More risk, so well. But be ready, yes, and live happy even with losses. This is wisdom. And the rest is English. The rest you are amazed because you are suffering. It's ridiculous. Obviously, you have a bigger family, it's more risky. It's like having a big ashrama. Obviously, there are more possibilities to some problem because it's a bigger ashrama. But this is your manifestation. You cry for a big family. Yes, you made many efforts for this big family. Yes, okay, now you tolerate the risk and the karma coming. It's like a business, yes, you risk a lot in a business, okay. You earn a lot of money, but you risk a lot of money. With a family, you can have a lot of happiness, yes, okay, but you risk more. Yogis are wise, and we decide to have little families or no family. Because bigger family is more problem, more room for problem. Even if nobody dies, yes, a son or a daughter is a pain. Because it's this tribute to Maya, we have to pay. You don't want, it's like how to be safe from poison. Don't be poisoned, first rule. After being poisoned, okay, this antidote. You understand? But the first rule is not, so how to be safe from a snake, the poison of a snake, don't be bitten by a snake. I'm not comparing family with the poison of a snake, but it's only an analogy for you to understand. It can be worse than poison, than a snake, if you are distracted. It's not that you are bringing children like an object, yes, or for filling your void, yes, in your life. They are spiritual souls inserted in human bodies with all the risky things there, yes. Even from the start, yes, some genetic problem and some problem, you will suffer your whole life. So it's risky. It's a risky situation. People have children like candies, having candy, buying candy. It's not so simple. They are ignorant. responsibility. For example, if I have a child, I have to form this child in Shaivism. But imagine the guy doesn't want Shaivism, yes? So it's a pain, all this. He wants a Vaishnavism, yes? I died here. So it's a pain. And you have to accept it. It should require a wisdom maybe you don't have. So better don't have a child if you're not wise enough. Yes? Check. Check your wisdom. Check all your possibilities in order not to blame anyone later, yes? Child included, yes? Or you included, yes? Because it's useless, yes? And check and do something later. But in ignorance, blah, 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 like this, is like in the same way you speak, having children is a disaster. Don't complain later. You suffer, but suffer alone, yes? Stop complaining. When my mother died, yes, it was a negligence by doctors, yes? In general, most of it. So I had two options. I started to go lawsuit to dog habits, to file a lawsuit on or to?
Lawsuit
on doctors, on hospital, on God, on this, or to suffer myself. If I have to suffer, I'm finished. Bad karma on my mother, okay, my bad karma, Peter, they finish. It's part of life, finish. I finish. One day I finish. Continue my life. Because it's not that we are passive, yes, and all is happening to us, and no, we are doing things, moving things, mistake after mistake. My mistake, I thought at the time, was to take her to that hospital, yes, bad hospital, my mistake. So it's not that all is another person, another, or the government, poor government, all the time with the government, yes. The government is the target for all, yes. The government. No, it's, I decided to take her to that hospital, but really I didn't decide because another hospital I wanted before was very busy with patients. So we had to move to the second hospital. Well, it's karma, destiny, whatever you want. But why all the time blame me, blame me, blame me? If there is someone guilty, we'll pay. Don't worry about it. If that doctor is guilty, yes, I remember one doctor, he will pay. No way to escape. Not with my hand, yes, we'll pay with another hand. By will pay. So this is like this. Or you can waste your life in lawsuit forever and suing people forever and suffering forever and manifesting all whole day with pamphlets and things forever and the government and forever. It's useless. Because yogis are supposed to be wiser. It's like this. Yogis in manifestation protesting because Maya did something. So yes. You hate Maya, destroy Maya in you. This is the real end of all your problems. Okay, we'll continue after lunch, now lunch, and after lunch we'll continue with our session of question and answers. Om Namah Shivaya.